So throughout my videos, I give you a lot of pointers along the way, and some of these will be things that you've probably heard before, but I want to just kind of give you an overview of a lot of miscellaneous technique that you should be thinking about, especially when you're spinning a flag. So we're going to kind of go through a few of those recommendations, things that you can be thinking about to solidify your technique and even more. So let's first start by talking about your toaster. So your toaster, if you think of an actual toaster in your kitchen where you've got the slots in it to put bread in, think of you and your flag as the bread and the atmosphere around you as the toaster. And so you really want to think about really keeping within that toaster here. So I've got like my flag in my toaster. And your toaster planes can go in a couple different ways. So I can be thinking about this kind of frontal vertical toaster, or I can be thinking this way alongside my body in this more horizontal toaster plane. So with that, I want to make sure that I'm trying to stay as close to my body as I can. And there's different recommendations for how you can do that depending on the move you're doing in that moment. But usually, you're going to want to think about having some flexibility in your wrist so that your wrist will allow you to be really close to your body in those moments, depending on what you're working on. So really try to sweep your different movements as close to your body as you can. Trying to think about really having flexibility in your shoulder as well, depending on what you're looking to do, so that you can stay within that toaster really nice and strong. You can also find, just gonna move the camera here. You can also find like a handy dandy fence or wall or something and work on your toaster there. So you can get right up along next to it and work within your toaster here so that if you're kind of hitting your fence or your wall, you know that you still need to work on pulling that shoulder back even further. Or if you're working here, you can think about working behind you in more of your horizontal plane and not hitting the fence there. Okay, so you also, when you're spinning, need to always think about your free arm. So if there's an arm and it's not on, you know, either connected with your flag here or holding onto your flag, you need to know what you're supposed to be doing with that as well. So there might most likely be something written into your choreography where it's going to say, this is where your arm is supposed to be. Or if there's not, then you need to find a good default position. The default position that I really like to use for free arms is just down here by my side. So I'm keeping my fingers bladed. I don't have any space in between there. Putting it just on my leg here, if it's my left arm, or my right leg, if it's my right arm. And you want to make sure that this isn't like a super rigid, like magnetic, like it has to be on this specific spot of my leg the whole time. Because if I'm trying to spin, and I'm like trying to move my body and I stay rigid to that one spot, you're gonna look really tense right here. So you still wanna stay alongside your leg, but you wanna allow that to be able to kind of slide freely down your leg and up your leg so that you can do your different movements here without that being too rigid. So free arm, very, very important. You don't want any like crazy T-Rex arms happening. Doesn't really make for the best action shots. So keep that in mind, always be practicing that default position if you don't have something written into your choreography there. Okay, a really important thing in color guard is your posture. So you really want to think about your posture no matter what piece of equipment you're spinning. So a lot of times there's going to be different dancings that are worked into your choreography, different movement things that are meant to be underneath your flag, maybe different positions that you're asked to do. No matter what though, you're always going to be thinking about your shoulders. Sometimes you will be asked to like collapse your shoulders in a particular movement, but in general, if you're not, even when you're bending, you can still have good strong posture up here and think about a lot of things. So just a default, position, if we were doing drop spins or something like that at right shoulder, you want to think about stacking your body. So I'm going to just think of my default position as my feet being together here. So I've got my toes and my heels in line. I have no space in between my knee, and those are nice and firmly planted. And then I'm just thinking about stacking the rest of my body on top of that. So I've got my knees right above that. I've got my hips in line. I'm thinking about all of of the vertebrae of my back stacking on top of that, all of the vertebrae of my neck on top of that, thinking about my shoulders being back and down so they're nice and relaxed. And then my head, I want to think about projecting. So when I'm projecting, this is how you're going to think about performing to your audience. Your audience is never going to be right here in front of you. They might, that's going to be pretty rare. So if they're not there in front of you, they're likely in the stands, whether that's the football stands or the gym stands, depending if it's color guard, winter guard. So you want to think about projecting, and an easy way to do this is take your hand and make a letter L, and then you want to put the pointer finger just under your chin here, and then take your L, and then push your chin up. So this is the angle that I should be performing to. I really want to think about connecting with my audience and performing up always. It also makes you look a lot more confident in your performance. Sometimes you just gotta fake it till you make it, so even if you're not feeling that confidence, you gotta show me that it looks like you do. And that's a really good way to do it. All right, so that's your posture. You really wanna think about lifting all the way through your body. Something you can think about doing is having a string running down the length of your body, especially through your spine. Think about pulling this up. So I'm gonna lift onto my toes here. And then as I set this back down, I'm just going to lightly set that back down. And as I lift it, I was thinking about every vertebrae really straightening and my legs really strengthening. And then as you set it back down, you'll still have that nice lift and that breathy feeling between all of the vertebrae of your spine as you maintain this really nice, strong posture. So as you are performing, you also want to think about not only projecting, but also just keeping it there. You don't want your eyes to be looking at the ground the whole time. Once again, not going to make you look the most confident in your choreography. There'll be moments where you're going to be asked to specifically, like, maybe look down at your flag, things like that. But in general, when you pull away from those moments, make sure that you then reconnect with your audience right away. Okay. You also, in that posture, want to think about your core. Your core is going to be so important in color guard, really strengthening those abs in there. That's going to make so many things better. It's going to make your posture really nice and strong. It's going to make your spinning nice and strong, your releases and your catches nice and strong. So squeeze your core. I say it all the time, but squeeze your core, and that's going to be great for you. Okay, so you also want to think about where you are in relation to your pole with your hands. Unless you're otherwise told, it's very likely that you're always going to be at the butt all the way, at the tab. These are kind of your two most common grabs. You will be in your cheater and in your silk and all over the place sometimes. But if you're not told otherwise, make sure that when you are supposed to have a grab here at the butt, that you're not exposing what I call your marshmallows. So that is where you want to think about this left hand here, if I'm coming right shoulder, being completely flush with the butt, so I'm not wrapping that pinky around, I'm not exposing what I call our marshmallows here, this white kind of looks like marshmallow, right? If you've got black tape on your pole, I like to call those your burnt marshmallows, which I love burnt marshmallows, personally, not everybody does. I don't like burnt marshmallows in color guard though, so have your burnt marshmallows or your regular marshmallows, and make sure you're flush with the pole. And that will be really good for your technique. It will allow you to move between movements in a proper way. And so avoid that wrapping. Once again, yeah, you don't want it to look like this. You want it to look like this, where I can see all of your knuckles kind of facing out here. So keep in mind where your marshmallows are and that they're kind of always hidden unless they're meant to be fully exposed like this. When it comes to performing, just have fun with it. You know, there's going to be different moves of different types of music. Some music is really happy and you really want to think about having that nice peppy smile. Make it look like you're having fun, because I hope you are. You know, there's going to be moves that are more dramatic and moody. So really thinking about how you can vary your facial expressions throughout that. Something that I learned back when I was a cheerleader was using the vowels. So you can kind of change look of your face by thinking of making the shape of a vowel in those different moods. So you can do this with really any mood. So if I'm thinking happy and I go through my A-E-I-O-U, I'm thinking thinking about this. I'm thinking A, E, I, O, U. And then you've got that really nice altered, you know, kind of look every time. You don't want to just be like this the whole time, where you've got this nice smile. It's great. Smiles are awesome. But you want to be really engaging too. So think about how you can vary that facial expression throughout, where you're not just do, but you're thinking. So really try to vary that. It doesn't have to be like every count you have a different look on your face, but you want to try to be more engaging throughout, where you're thinking, and doing different things with your face there. Same can be done with like a sad mood. So you can try this on your own, in your mirror at home as well. So if I'm thinking sad through my vowels, I'm thinking, okay. As well, so make sure you're really using those and the different ways that you can change your face. That's going to make a really big difference for you. So, hey, E, I, O, U. Or with your sad ones, A, E, I, O, U. So really play with that a little bit and think about how you can change up those facial expressions when you're working on your varied performances as well. Okay, you also in Color Guard want to avoid, especially when you're working with your flag, getting sales. So getting a sale is when you have something like this going on, where you don't have your full silk out nice and pretty, but it gets kind of caught, especially in the top butt here. Or maybe you have a silk that specifically has like torn bits in the design. That's something you want to try to avoid getting caught up in that top butt as well. So if this happens to you, you want to try to get this out as subtly as possible. So if I'm here and I'm trying to go into like a flutter, let's say, I'm going to think about going down and just trying to pull this out as subtly as I can so that I don't have that sail when I come up and behind you. Because this does not look quite as pretty. Also, when you're going into your tosses, it's going to be a lot harder to do a toss if you've got this kind of tripping you up. You're not going to be able to get the kind of rotation that you want to your toss. It's going to be a lot harder. You have to put a lot more strength into it. And it's not really going to spin at the plane that you want it to, especially if you're trying to go into a 45. So build that skill over time. Trying to get out those sails as subtly as possible. You know, just trying to work through that. Trying to find those good moments in your choreography where you're not having to go here and think, hectic, trying to get my sail out, yeah? You want to try to make that as subtle and smooth as possible where we didn't even notice that you had a sail to begin with. So think about that and try to find those good moments in your choreography to just pull those out without it being too noticeable. Except, you know what? People will notice and they will applaud you for that effort when you can get it out without it being this big to-do. So that is something that you can really build on as a performer as well. All right, well, I hope you found some of these techniques really helpful. These are things that you can really start working to keep in mind as you continue to learn how to spin, learn different fundamentals, learn different choreography and routines. Just always trying to apply all of these different concepts. It's gonna make you look like such a strong spinner as you start to work through all of these over time. And at a certain point, you won't have to think about it anymore. You'll just be thinking about, I'm having fun, I'm performing, I'm doing this with my technique, and it'll just feel natural at a certain point. So really work on building those so that it'll just become muscle memory for you over time.